Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. In this video series, I am going to explain you the heap sort technique. Starting from its introduction, now I am at the stage to explain you the actual sorting with the help of heap. Sorting is done with the help of either max heap or mean heap data structure. From this, the sorting with max heap is already explained in my previous video. In this current video, I am going to focus on heap sort using mean heap data structure. In this video, I am going to cover the steps required for sorting, and that I am going to explain with the solved example. So now let's start with the heap data structure or the sorting with the help of heap data structure. Just to recall the things, these are the types or the examples of max heap data structure and mean heap data structure. What are max heap data structure, mean heap data structure, how they differ with each other, what are the properties, they have already explained in my previous video. For your reference, I am providing you a shortcut link in this right up corner. So if the max heap tree is there, always every root node is having the maximum value than that of its children node, and if the mean heap data structure is there, the root node is having the value which is minimum or less than its children node. So this is the main difference, from which I am going to use the mean heap data structure for the sorting purpose. Now let's see what are the steps using heap sort with the minimum heap tree. Now, as I have already explained that we are going to use the mean heap data structure or mean heap property, so the first step is you must have the mean heap with you. The values which you want to search, which you want to sort, that should be arranged in a complete binary tree which follows all the property of mean heap. That will be your first step. How to construct a complete binary tree from the given set of values and which will follow the mean heap property, all these things are already explained in the previous videos. Still, if you want to go through the complete binary tree, I am going to provide you a shortcut link in this right up corner. Now, I am assuming that all of you are knowing the concept of complete binary tree and how to construct a mean heap by applying different Heapify functions at the root nodes or a parent node, how you will get the mean heap. I assume that all of you are knowing all these things. Now this will be your first step, that keep ready the mean heap data structure who follows the mean heap property. The next step is, as the heap tree is your mean heap tree, it means that your root element is the smallest element from your set of values. Now what you want to do in this second step is that you are going to remove the root element, and that we are going to put into the last element of the tree. Other way round, whenever we are going to construct, we are going to implement all these things, that we are going to do with the help of an array. So whatever is the root element, that I am going to replace with the last element of my array, and what was the last element, that I am going to swap with the root element. So here, in short, I am swapping the elements who are present at the root position and the last position of my array. That will be your second step. What will be a third step? So third step is, after swapping both the elements, whatever was the last element or the root element actually, which is present at the last position, was the smallest element and which is at the last position, who occupies its proper position. So that's why our next step is to reduce the size of heap or the array by one. After reducing the size, whatever the last element was replaced with the root item. Now it's time to check whether the newly constructed tree is satisfying the main heap property or not. If it is not, you need to apply the Heapify function. You need to convert it into the main heap, and the smallest element which is present now after heapifying, the smallest element which is present at the root node, that you need to remove again or replace with the last item. Means, in short, I would like to explain that after reducing the size, check whether the constructed tree is main heap or not. If it is not, apply Heapify. After applying Heapify, your tree is ready with the main heap property. If tree is ready with main heap property, means newly created node is nothing but your smallest element that you need to replace with the current last item. Here I am going to ignoring the last position which is already filled in the last iteration of this heap sort. So in this way, repeatedly you will perform above steps, and at the end you will be having the array which will be in the sorted order, in the descending order. Because in the first iteration, what was the smallest element from the, all the set of values is setting the position, last position of your given array, and repeatedly you are going to select the root item which is the smallest one in the rest of values, and you are putting that into the last position from the current set of values that is reduced after every iteration. So this sorting technique is also just similar to the selection sort, as we are selecting the smallest item and that we are putting at the proper position. So in this way the sorting is performed. Now here we will start with the example, solved example. Now let's consider this is the heap data structure. Now let's check whether this heap data structure is satisfying the main heap property or not. So now let's see every parent node is satisfying the main heap property. So we can say that my heap is ready for the sorting. So how many values I am going to sort? I am going to sort different 6 values. They are stored in this format in my array. These are the index position and this is the array. Always root node is at the 0th position. Next level is at the next 2 consecutive position. Next level is at the next 4 consecutive position, and so on. This is the property of complete binary tree. So in this way the array is used to store all the values of my heap tree. What is the relationship between array elements, parent node and its child node? That is already explained in my previous video. You must have gone through all these things, so there must not be any query about how to store all these values in my array. Still, if you are having any query, please go back, go to the types of tree wala video from my channel, and you will come to know that how these values are going to be stored, as well as you will come to know all these things from the introduction to heap, the first video from this lecture series. Now let's start with the sorting. What is your first step? First step was, what we are going to do, we are going to replace or swap the root node and the last value of my array, that is 1 and 12. Now let's see, this is the main heap which is ready to sort, and the next step is replace the root with the last number and remove the smallest one, which is after replacement which is going to take the last position. So that I need to remove. So after removing, how your array will look like this. So 12 is at 0th position, 1 is at the last position, and now here you can see that 1 is the smallest element and securing its own position. Now let's move forward. That is, what is the next step is to reduce the heap, size of heap. I have reduced the size of heap, and now I am going to consider only the 5 values that are starting from 0 to 4. I am not considering now onwards the 6th value for the sorting purpose, which is already sorted. So now only 5 values I am going to consider, and in the same way only 5 values are there available in my min heap. Whether this is a min heap, this is not a min heap. So that's why what we need to do, this is only the complete binary tree. It should have to focus on the construction of min heap. So what we need to do, we need to apply the heapify function. After heapifying at the parent node 12, how your true tree will look like. So as this is the min heap tree, where we need to think about its children node, which one is the smallest will take the root position. So 5 is the smallest one, will take the root position. So in this way I will swap the 5 and 12 and their positions too in my array. So this will look like this. Now let's see how the array will look like. So 5 and 12 are swapped their position in this way, and now my tree, let's check whether this tree is satisfying the min heap property or not. Here you can see that this subtree is not satisfying the min heap property, where the root node is greater than that of its children nodes. So what we need to do, again we need to apply the heapify at parent node 12, and after that my tree will look like this, where from both the children, that is 10 and 6 from the previous figure, 6 is the smallest one, 6 will take a root position, and 12 is replaced with the position of 6, and my array will look like this. Now here you can see that my tree is ready, min heap tree is ready to sort. So after heapifying, so this was, we were at the step number 3, we were heapifying the tree to make it as a min heap. Now as my min heap tree is ready, now again we are at the step 1, that the my min heap tree is ready. What is my next step? Next step is replace the root with the last number and remove the smallest one. So 5 is the root and the last number is 12 from my array, you can see that. So I am going to replace this 12 with 5 and 5 with 12. So after replacing all these things, how my tree is going to look like? So the tree will look like this, where 12 is my root node and 5 is my last node. Now as the 5 is my last node, what is my next step is to remove the element from my tree. Here you can see that there are positions, and now reduce the size by detaching or by removing the last node. After removing the last node, the two values are already in the sorted form. So as these two values are already in the sorted form, the tree will look like this. So here what we need to do, after this we need to apply the heapify function. As I will apply where it was, the 12 was at the root position, and I will apply the heapify by setting the position of 6 as a root. Here you can see that the 5 and 1 are already in the sorted form, 6 is its parent node or a root node whose children node are 12 and 9. So this tree is already in the min heap tree, or it satisfies the min heap property. Now let's see whether this tree is satisfying the min heap property. No, it is not. So what we need to do, we need to again apply the heapify function, and now here you can see that the whole tree is satisfying the min heap property. In the same way my array will look like this. Now after that, this tree is ready for the sorting. This tree is min heap tree, and which is ready for the sorting. Now what will be the next step? Next step is to replace the root node with the last number and remove the smallest one. So I am detaching 6 from my tree, and after that we have replaced both the nodes, that is root node and the last node. They will look like this, and after removing it from the tree, I am going to reduce the size of heap by 1, and in this way After reducing the size, here you can see that now the three elements are in the sorted form. Now this tree, now let's check whether this tree is satisfying the mean heap property or not. You can see that this tree is also not satisfying the mean heap property. So what will be our next step is to perform Heapify at the parent node 12. And after performing Heapify, my tree will look like this and my array is also looking like this. Now let's check whether this tree is ready to sort, whether this tree is satisfying all the properties of mean heap. Yes, it is satisfying all the properties and ready for sorting. So what is next step? Next step is to replace the root node with the last node of your tree. So now I am detaching 9 from my tree. After detaching 9 from a tree, my tree will look like this, because after detaching it, the size will get reduced and tree will look like this. Now here you can see that the 4 items have set their positions. So in this way, only now 2 elements I am going to consider for the sorting. Now let's check whether this tree is satisfying the mean heap property. No, that's why I'll apply the Heapify function. After applying Heapify function, my 10 node is going to become a root node and my array will look like this. Now let's check whether this is satisfying the mean heap property. Yes, that's why my tree is ready for the sorting. My mean heap tree is ready for the sorting. So what is my next step is to replace the root node, and it is going to be swapped with the last element. So 10, I'm going to, before that I have swapped the positions 10 and 12, and I am going to detach 10 from my tree. After detaching 10 from my tree, I am going to reduce the size. After reducing the size, only a single element will be there for the sorting, and these are the 5 elements have taken their secured their own positions. Now a single node is there. There is no any comparison required because a single node is there, and that's why this tree is already in the mean heap format. That's why the next step is directly consider it as the 0th position node or the last node, because no comparison is required, no any replacement is required, as a single node is there. So in this way, my data is in the sorted form, which is in the descending order. Here you can notice that if I am going to use the mean heap data structure, your data must be sorted in the descending order. And in a previous video, you must have seen that if I have used the max heap data structure, data is sorted in the ascending order. So here you can apply your own logic to find out whether the sorted data you must require in ascending order or in descending order. If you want that in ascending order, do use the max heap data structure. If you require the data in descending order, then you have to use the min heap data structure for the sorting. So let's hope you must have understood what I have learned, what I have explained to you. Thank you friends for listening and watching my video. If you like the video, please do not forget to give the comment. If you like the video and its content, please like my video, subscribe my channel Tech Talks, share it with your friends, and keep the bell ringing, because ringing bell will give you the notification of new videos. Here I am providing you the subscription link. Please subscribe my channel Tech Talks. Here I am providing you the next lecture of this series, and please stay tuned with my channel Tech Talks. Thank you.